Should you cancel your VUL or variable life plan? This is one of the most frequently asked questions sent to us here at Pinoy Money Academy. And the story usually goes like this. They went to a bank, got offered an investment, or they had coffee with a friend, got offered an investment, and without really understanding what they were buying, what they were saying yes to, they said yes. After all, they were making an investment. Investments are good, right? And they trust this bank or this friend who offered to them anyway. Now, several weeks, months, or years later, they do more research about their so-called investment. And lo and behold, they discover that many financial experts, advocates, and articles advise against variable life plans and VULs. And now they get worried. What can they do? Should they just cancel or keep it? What do you do if you find yourself in this situation? That's what we'll answer in this video. But before we go to the factors to consider, please note that this is not a video about why VULs aren't recommended investments. So we won't go into the pros and cons of the VUL and other variable life policies. Instead, you can see the links about that topic below this video. This video is for those who have already invested in a VUL and you're not sure what you should be doing next. With that said, let's get started. Here are the three factors to consider on whether or not you should continue or cancel your VUL or your variable life plan policy. Factor number one, do you have financial dependence today or in the near future? VULs are dual purpose. They serve as life insurance so that your financial dependence will be taken care of financially if you suddenly pass away. And they serve as an investment in the fortunate event that you live a long and prosperous life. So, the first question we consider is, do you even need the life insurance component? Because if you don't have financial dependence, if you don't have kids yet, or if your parents are doing well and don't really depend on your income, or you are not providing for your younger siblings or any other relatives, if no one is financially dependent on you, then you really don't need the life insurance component of the VUL. And that gives one point for canceling. But if you do have financial dependence, then this points to keeping the VUL. Let's now go to the next factor. Factor number two is, how long have you been paying? Has it been just a few weeks, a year, 2 years, 5 years? First thing that you should know is that VULs and most insurance plans have what's called a cooling off period. Meaning, this is a period where you can still refund and ask for your money back. This cooling off period is 15 days for most plans, but can be different from company to company. Now, you can still ask for a refund even if the cooling off period has elapsed if you're able to prove that deceptive or unethical means were used to sell you the product. But in general, the longer the time that has elapsed, the less likely you'll be able to claim a refund and get all your money back. So if it's just been a few days and you don't need the life insurance, go and cancel it ASAP. You dodged a bullet this time. But what if you've been paying for a year or more for the plan? Can you still get your money back? Not all of it. That would actually depend on the value of your investment. Remember earlier that we said that a VUL both has a life insurance component and an investment component. Well, what happens in the first years of the VUL, the money you pay goes to the insurance portion. For example, if the plan you're on is about 22,000 pesos a year, here's a sample of how much you'll be able to withdraw. On year one, 4,000 pesos will be the withdrawable amount. The rest went to pay for the insurance portion. The following year, year number two, again, you paid 22,000, the withdrawable amount stays at 4,000 pesos. Most of your payment, again, went to pay off for the insurance component. On year number three, the withdrawable amount becomes 12,000. So more of your money is going into the investment portion. Then on year four, after paying 22,000 again, the withdrawable amount goes to 27,000. This time, majority of your money is going into the investment portion. On your year five and onwards, nearly all of the money you put is essentially added to the investment component. So, How do you think this decision through? When does it make sense to just keep paying or let go of it while it's still early? Our recommendation is, if you've only been investing for your VUL for a good 1 to 3 years and you don't really need life insurance, then cancel it. But if it's been more than that, then might as well keep it and finish the plan because the insurance costs have been paid for through your diligent investing. Now, you might be wondering, ay, sayang naman ang pera ko if I cancel. This brings us to the third factor to consider. Factor number 3, where will you use the excess money? When you cancel your VUL, you'll mainly get 2 things. Number 1 is freed up cash flow. Basically, if you used to be paying 22,000 pesos per year and you're no longer paying for that anymore, well, that's freed up cash flow. The second thing you'll get is the lump sum of your withdrawable amount, depending on how long you have been investing. And this could be a few thousands or a few hundred thousands. So the thing to look at here is not how much you've already paid for, but the future money you are freeing up for yourself. So yes, you might have paid already 50,000 pesos for the past 2 years, and sayang nga naman kung biglang itigil. But think about the next 8 years on where your money is going, because that's the bigger amount, yung perang hindi mo pa na ipangbabayad. That's why the third factor is, where will you use the excess money? If you plan on using the money for something that's not going to help you financially, like for traveling or buying that new phone or for shopping, then our recommendation is might as well keep the VUL. It may not be the best insurance and investment combo, but at least it's an investment that will serve you and your family in the future. So keep it. But if you plan to use the money for something better, say you found a cheaper insurance plan with better coverage, or you want to invest in a fund that gives much better returns, or you want to use it for something that can potentially increase your income, or you'll use it to pay off your debts. Anything that improves your cash flow and your financial foundation, then we say yes. Cancel it and optimize your money. And those are the 3 factors to consider if you should be canceling your VUL. Let's quickly review. Factor number 1, do you have financial dependence today or in the near future? If yes, keep the VUL. If no, cancel it. Factor number 2, how long have you been investing in it? If within the cooling off period of normally 15 days, then cancel it. If within 1 to 3 years, cancel it. If more than that, consider keeping it. Factor number 3, where will you use the excess money? If you'll use it to better your financial life, for a cheaper insurance plan, for a better investment, for a higher income, if you know how to make better use of the money so your financial foundation is strengthened, then cancel the VUL. But if you'll use it to YOLO, to shop, or anything that really doesn't serve your financial future, might as well keep it. With all these 3 factors, I know that some people are going to be getting, okay, all 3 factors point to keeping it, or all 3 factors point to just canceling it. But what if I get a cancel, keep, cancel, or keep, keep, cancel? Well, we've thought of all the possible combinations, and here are our recommendations for each and why. Check out the table below and see how it does for you. What combination do you have, and what's our recommendation? And that's it for our episode on should you cancel your VUL or variable life plan. Hey there, J3 here. Did you enjoy this episode? If you did, well, there are 2 things you can do right now to continue your journey towards financial freedom and abundance. First, subscribe here in our Pinoy Money Academy channel so that you'll get updates on our new episodes, so that I can send you free training videos on everything and anything about money. Second, if you want faster results towards financial freedom and abundance, you can subscribe to our 5 Pillars of Wealth online video series. This is a free series of 3 eye-opening, life-changing videos where you'll learn about the 5 most essential concepts needed for anyone to become wealthy. And if you don't know these 5 pillars of wealth, well, you're disadvantaged in your journey. You can view this training for free online just by going to the following URL. That's pinoymoneyacademy.com/5PW. The link is displayed here on the video. Again, the link is pinoymoneyacademy.com/5PW. I look forward to seeing you in our next episode. Until then, always remember that wealth is a choice, so choose to be wealthy.